In this video we're going to have the Samsung QN65LST7TAFXZA review. We will have a detailed look on the various features this product possesses. This video will help you decide whether this television is perfect for your needs. We provided a link on the description to give you the best prices on the market right now. The Samsung The Terrace is a great QLED TV designed for outdoor use. It gets exceptionally bright, providing good visibility in broad daylight, and its high contrast ratio allows it to produce deep blacks when viewing at night. It has a fast response time and a black frame insertion feature to further improve motion clarity, making it great for watching sports or for gaming. It also has low input lag and a 120Hz refresh rate, but there's no variable refresh rate support to minimize screen tearing when gaming. Its wide color gamut, high peak brightness, and full array local dimming help to deliver an incredible HDR experience, with vibrant colors and highlights that pop. Unfortunately, its VA panel has subpar viewing angles, which isn't ideal for big parties or wide seating arrangements. Also, it's designed to be wall-mounted but doesn't include a wall mount or a stand. The Samsung Terrace has an outstanding design that looks very similar to the Samsung The Frame 2020, but it's thicker and more robust. This TV is meant to be wall-mounted and doesn't come with a stand. The feet in the picture above were purchased separately from a third party. Unfortunately, the Samsung Terrace doesn't come with a stand, and Samsung doesn't sell one either. The third-party stand in our pictures was purchased separately. The back of the TV is all metal, except for the plastic panel covering the inputs. There are small cable routes at the bottom of the panel to allow the cables to pass through for cable management. The panel is held by screws to protect the inputs from any potential water damage. Exceptional build quality. It's almost entirely made out of metal, and it feels incredibly well built. There's no flex or noticeable gaps. It's advertised to have IP55 water resistance, however, it isn't something that we test. The Samsung Terrace has an outstanding contrast ratio, further improved by a full array local dimming feature. This results in blacks that look deep and inky. The Samsung Terrace has a decent full array local dimming feature. It handles blooming well by averaging the surrounding brightness, but some blooming is still visible due to the TV's sheer brightness. Subtitles aren't as bright or distracting, similar to how the Samsung Q90T QLED handles them. Depending on the scene, some small bright objects in dark scenes are crushed, such as the stars in the opening sequence of Star Wars. It's slow at transitioning between zones, as it usually trails behind the test pattern for about 1 second. The Samsung Terrace has an impressive HDR color gamut. It has outstanding coverage of the commonly used DCI-P3 color space and decent coverage of the wider rec. 2020. The EOF doesn't follow the PQ curve well, resulting in most scenes appearing too bright. The game mode EOF is better, but some scenes are still overbrightened. If you find HDR content too dim, set contrast enhancer to high, ST.2084 and shadow details to max. These settings provide a much brighter image, as you can see in this EOF. Inputs are HDMI 3, USB 1, Digital Optical Audio Out 1, Analog Audio Out 3.5mm 1, Analog Audio Out RCA 0, Tuner, Cable / Ant 1, Ethernet 1. There's an input on the Samsung Terrace labeled HDBT. It allows you to connect an optional external HDBT transmitter, so you can use a single cable to transmit all data to the TV for a clean setup, similar to the One Connect box on the Samsung The Frame 2020. It requires a Cat 6 Ethernet cable. Samsung's Tizen OS is a very user-friendly platform and runs very smoothly. There's only a minor bug with Dolby Digital over HDMI ARC, where the connected receiver indicates that the decoder is turned off even when it's on. However, this issue was resolved on the receiver and might not be related to the TV itself. The remote control is slightly different from other high-end Samsung TVs, however, the button layout is the same. There are dedicated buttons to access Netflix, Prime Videos, and Samsung TV Plus, as well as a button for the ambient mode, which displays pieces of art or photos when the TV isn't in use. The remote is advertised to have IP56 water resistance, but it isn't something that we test. The Samsung Terrace is a great TV overall. It stands out for its exceptional build quality and high peak brightness. However, unless you need a TV specifically for outdoor use, there are better TVs that cost much less. Where to buy? You can get the Samsung QN65LST7TAFXZA through the link below in the description. We have checked to ensure those are the best price in the market right now. Thanks for watching.